The Eastern or Indic metaphysical and philosophical tradition is embedded in myth and magic. For some, that lends it additional charm. For others, the mythic and the magical only strengthen their skepticism, because surely nothing serious can be founded on fairy tales about sorcerers and flying chariots. Carl Gustav Jung has, however, suggested that human beings have two ways of thinking and responding to the world around them. A directed, rational cause-and-effect way on one side, and a diffuse, intuitive, fantasy mode on the other. A tendency that will not go away no matter how hard we prod it with the goad of reason. Even if we banish its poetry from our waking lives, it flourishes in our dreams, where we can't root it out. Indeed, logic, rationalism, and the scientific method are fairly recent acquisitions of the human race. Fragile cuttings, hardly yet grafted onto the tough old stock that we loosely call superstition. Superstition was all our species had for hundreds of thousands of years, and somehow we have survived because of or in spite of it. That anything as ancient as yoga is rooted in superstition, and the supernatural should therefore come as no surprise. In the Western world, logic stands on one side and myth on the other. Objective analysis and measurement, controlled experimentation, statistics and natural sciences are all immensely valuable. Indeed, they were as valuable to the ancient Hindus as to the classical Greeks. Hindus as well as Greeks used such hard everyday tools of the mind as mathematics, logic, and grammar, but it is worth pointing out that Aryabhata in the 5th century AD first wrote about pi in a poem. The two ways of seeing things, the logical and the poetical, are not necessarily hostile to each other, just because in our modern world, few physicists are poets, and few poets are physicists.